Hi guys, in this tutorial we are going to see what is Hystrix and how to use it in microservices. So basically Hystrix is a fault tolerance library provided by Netflix through which we can stop delegation of failure from one service to another service, and this Hystrix internally following the circuit breaker design pattern. So it's just one terminology. So in short, circuit breaker can be used to check the availability of external service. External service in the sense we can say like the database connection, and we can say like the web service call, and alternatively we can say this circuit breaker detects the failure and prevents the application from trying to perform the action until it's safe to retry. Okay, so normally this Hystrix implementation will be helpful if we have the distributed application. So let me show you one small diagram. This one is my distributed application where request come to microservice, then again it will delegate to service 2, and this service 2 again communicate to service 4, and then service 4 communicate to 3, like it's a interlink with each other. So suppose assume I request came to 1, and in service 2 the service 2 connected to database, so there is some timeout issue, database connection issue, so my service 1 will be impacted. Suppose assume in service 4 there will be some network issue, so for service 4 it link to 2, so 2 will be impacted, and it link to microservice 1, so 1 also impacted. So here like the one process failure is delegating from one microservice to another microservices, so we can stop it, we can break it specific to the microservices using the Hystrix. Okay, so let's see one more architecture which we are going to develop. Suppose I am developing one Book My Show application. Okay, so this Book My Show connected to PayATM for payment related things, and once this payment done, it connected to notification for email related things or SMS related things, and again some external services is connected to Book My Show. Suppose assume as a user I open my Book My Show application, and I am going to book a show using this PayATM vendor, and there may be some database connection issue in my PayATM. Okay, so my entire application will not work due to a one microservice fault. Okay, similarly in notification there will be some SMTP protocol issue or some less bandwidth, so for that also the other service will not work. So how we can optimize this using the Hystrix? Suppose there will be failure in one service, instead of delegate it to other, we need to break that circuit specific to that microservices. If notification service is failing, we need to break that in notification microservice. Okay, so now let's create these three microservices, then we'll enable Hystrix on this Book My Show, and we'll show how it works. So let's create the project. First I am creating the email service. Okay, name it email service. Email service something note right here. Change the package here, notification. Okay, now I'm adding here only web. You can check the version I'm using, 2.0.1. Let's import it, application imported. Similar way, create one more microservices for notification. This is we created email service, now create for the PayATM. okay, create your something like Paytm service. So change the package here, Paytm. Okay, here also I just want to expose one REST endpoint, so just add only the web dependency. Let's import it. Now in email service, let's write one endpoint, annotate this class as @REST controller, write a method public string send email, return some dummy value like email service called, okay, annotated here @getMapping, pass the URL here, something like send, create the root URL here, email service. Okay, now create Paytm service. Let me copy this to annotation. Okay, here also I want to expose one REST endpoint, and both endpoint will consume from the Book My Show services. So here mention emails, what is that, Paytm payment service. Okay, let's copy paste this method also. We'll change the URL and message. Pay and the method name like pay now, else payment process, okay. Here in email service and Paytm service, we just added one REST endpoint and we expose it, we'll consume it from Book My Show. So let's create the Book My Show microservices. Change it to Book My Show, something like booking service. Change the package here, Book My Show. Okay, here we want to enable the histories, and we are going to consume both email service and Paytm service. So add web and add the histories related dependency. If you want to enable the histories dashboard, you can add the histories dashboard's dependency as well. Okay, so create it. It downloading the latest version jar, so it may take few second. You can check it's downloading the histories provided by the Netflix. Okay, so in Book My Show, let's annotation these two. So I copy entire. Okay, let's write it REST controller. REST controller. And here write a method who will consume the both web services, REST web services, email and payment. Okay, public string book show. Okay, to consume a REST service we need the REST template, so create a bin of REST template, public REST template, template then return new REST template. okay, and annotate here @bean, okay, and inject here the REST template. Okay, injecting using auto add. Now in book show, let's get the response like email service response. Call the template as both the method are get, so call get for object, pass the URL and the response type. We are just returning the string return type, so pass here string.class. Here we need to pass the URL, so let's copy. This is for payment service, okay, and now pass the URL here, http localhost 8181, okay. Then we have the, let me check the exact URL. Email service and send. Similarly, for this payment service also we need to provide the URL localhost. We can deploy all the microservices on same port as we are using embedded Tomcat, so we'll change the port in both the services. Check the URL in payment service. Payment service and pay, okay. Now we deployed email service on port 8181 and payment service on port 8282. So let's change the port on both the services. Server.port 8282. Similarly, let's change in email service. Okay. Now, from this, we consumed both the services, email and payment. So now, return those response. Email service response. Then I'm just appending a new line and then payment service. Okay. So as we are going to implement Hystrix here, annotate @enable Hystrix, okay, and here we need to mention like the fallback command who will handle the fault tolerance in my application. Or Hystrix command, okay, it should be, yeah, Hystrix command, and there pass the group key. You can pass any name. I'm giving Java tech key. Pass the command key. I'm giving the same, okay. Then pass the fallback method, okay. So let's create a fallback method, public string book my show fallback, okay, return some dummy message service gateway failed, okay. So in we need to write the fallback method and the return type of fallback method should be same return type from your controller endpoint, okay. So pass the method name here. So while invoking email service or payment service, if there is any like network issue or DB issue, connection issue, instead of terminate the program or showing the error message, that 503 or the error code, it should give the proper message. So any process is failing, it will not like propagate that same error message to the every layer. It should display unique message. Okay. So in this method we enable the hystrix. So let's write one more method where we will not enable hystrix and we'll check the difference with hystrix and without hystrix. Okay. So let's remove this hystrix related annotation. Annotated here, get mapping, we didn't configure the URL mapping, book now. Okay, so here also annotate book now without hystrix. Okay, so here change book show without hystrix. Okay, so let me show you here. We injected REST template, we write two endpoint where in one first one we enable the hystrix and the second one we didn't enable the hystrix. Okay, and we write our fallback method, that is the book my show fallback. Okay, so now let's up each services. First let's up me the email services. It will be run on port 8181. You can check it up on 8181. Now run the Paytm services. It will run on port 8282. Now let's run our main application Book My Show where we enable the hystrix. Run a Java application. It will run on port 8080. As we are not configured any port change server.port, it will take the default port. Okay, you can check it up on 8080. You can check all the three services are up. Okay, now let's hit the URL on our postman book now. In this book now we enable the hystrix. Okay, let me hit it http localhost 8080 book now. Okay, let's hit the URL. We are getting email service called and payment service called. Okay, now let's hit without hystrix. We are getting response on both the cases because we have developed three services, Book My Show, email service and Paytm service. There is no issue like email service also running fine and Paytm also running fine. Assume in my Paytm there will be some database timeout connection issue, so it is down manually, I shut down that. Okay, so now only Book My Show and email service is up, but in Book My Show I am invoking both the services. Okay, so if one service will not work means my application will be got terminated. Okay, so let's see it without hystrix how it will behave. Now I am hitting without hystrix. Okay, as one service is off, so it is showing 500 internal server IO error or get request. It's like it's showing this service endpoint is not active, and there will be some connection issue, okay, and run it with Hystrix, you will get the service gateway failed. Okay, so what happened here in case of where we didn't enable the Hystrix, it's propagating the raw error message. Okay, and in case of where you enable the Hystrix in book now URL hitting, it's providing the fallback response to us. So if it is the distributed application and I have integrated like more than like assume 7-8 services and each are interacting to the all REST endpoint, so there instead of like display the raw error message, we can display the fallback response. So in this case the fault will not be delegated to the other services, okay. So that you can monitor using the Hystrix dashboard also. So in my next tutorial I will upload how to enable Hystrix dashboard and how to monitor the JVM related stuff, thread related stuff in Hystrix dashboard, okay. That's it about this particular video. If anyone have any doubt or concern, you can add a comment, and thanks for watching this video.